look in the world today, not only today, but throughout history. Christians killing Jews, Muslims killing Jews, Christians killing Christians and Muslims killing each other, Hindus and Buddhists killing each other, Buddhists and Christians killing each other, Sikhs and Hindus killing each other, Muslims and Hindus killing each other. Yes, isn't that very much a part of history? And it's very much going on today. Protestants and Catholics killing each other. Why, if there's one God who's a God of love, why does religion in his name divide us and cause us to hate each other? Does it make sense? If we seek the essence of those great spiritual paths, we find the unity. We find the transform, really, what it means to be a Hindu or a Muslim or a Jew or a Jain or a Buddhist or a Christian or a Zoroastrian or whatever we may be, to transform our character, to be an instrument of love and compassion. The Bible says you can judge a tree by its fruit. Are we actually following our religion? The test is, are we meek and humble? Are we forgiving? Are we unselfish? That's the essence of every religion, to develop that character. So yes, from a spiritual perspective of our traditions, without the concept of the divine, we could be good people, we could be pious people, we could be charitable people. But to actually access that ecstatic divine love within our hearts and be instruments of that love, for that to connect to the divine and understand the essence that is required. So we could be very, very good people to a certain extent, but to understand the eternal nature and the eternal love within us, a path that brings us to the divine is necessary. But that path should be inclusive rather than egoistic. Does that answer your question? Because the conflict between so-called spiritual paths is not based on religion. It's based on arrogance, insecurity, and envy. And we take those qualities and we try to empower them and facilitate them in the name of God. That's very dangerous. Humility and gratitude are foundational qualities in all the great spiritual teachings. In my tradition, there's a beautiful verse that is considered so essential if we want to really access the divine. Whether we are professors or politicians or farmers or businessmen or financiers or mothers or fathers or students or swamis, if we apply this principle, we can access the divine. Trinadapi sunichena taror iba sehishnuna amanina manadena kirtaniya sadahari. To strive to be humble like the grass, tolerant and forgiving like a tree, eager to offer all respect to others and not to demand or expect respect for oneself. When we really want these qualities, when we strive for them, then when we chant the name of God, when we pray to God, we will directly access and experience the beauty of the divinity within ourselves and be empowered by that. Thank you very, very much. It's really an honor to be among all of you here at the University of Massachusetts.